can the diaphragm tell us about the clinical use of pressure support or any other modes of mechanical ventilation? Dr. Stefano Muttini works in the Medical Surgical Intensive Care Department of Vimercate, Italy, together with 8 other physicians. They met the challenge of treating over 390 patients during 2014 in their 8-bed ICU. In the past, Dr. Muttini and colleagues were looking to work more efficiently with better treatment quality.
Our aim in the ICU is to gain time restoring altered parameters using most of the time a symptomatic therapy in addition to causal therapy in order to help the patient. Those parameters are provided by vital signs such as physical examination. For the hemodynamic vital signs are pressure, like central venous pressure, invasive blood pressure, pulmonary artery pressure. For the kidney function, a vital sign is diuresis. In respiratory terms, we can consider 2 vital signs, only respiratory rate, tidal volumes, and oxygenation. Symptomatic therapy carries side effects that should be minimized. We know that ventilator therapy may initiate or exacerbate lung injury. Protective ventilation has become standard of care to prevent ventilator-associated lung injury. More recently, another side effect involving diaphragmatic weakness has been investigated. It is known as ventilator-induced diaphragmatic dysfunction. We need more vital signs from the respiratory system, and the scientific research in recent years is focusing, among others, on the diaphragm function. It seems important to allow as much diaphragmatic activity as possible in order to minimize the risk of VIDD and to determine how to promote the diaphragmatic effort during mechanical ventilation.